today we got secondary squats, secondary bench, 12 days out, Hunter Performance Center. Let's get it, baby. Oh man.
Everyone, I'm Danny, under 74 kilo lifter. You know, we are here at Breakthrough. Behind the camera, we've got James, my cousin, smiling right now. But yeah, we're just vibing. You know, we've got Andrew over there. It's a good day. It's the Monday. Alhamdulillah. I like Matty V.
Oh yeah? Introduce yourself.
I'm Chris.
Yeah, keep going.
Yeah, a powerlifter, 66 kilogram class. A bit shy from the camera. That's pretty much it.
What's your experience like at BT?
It's good. It's really good. Great equipment, like 16 combo racks. Never a lack of combo racks available. Good accessory machines. Gets the job done. Yeah, good community. Some of the strongest people in Australia.
Oh no, this is not a promo skit. This is more like your own experience. Like we're doing it for Matty B's vlog.
Yeah.
So it's just like...
Oh man, I'm camera shy. I don't know. It's good. I've enjoyed it. It's like different from Melbourne, which is where I'm from, obviously. Because in Melbourne, there's no gyms like this, like with like 16 combo racks. With like people who take training as seriously. It's good.
Excellent. What are you doing today?
Just benching and then accessories.
Excellent, excellent. Who's your coach?
Huh?
Who's your coach?
No one right now, but we'll see.
He's on the market!
So I've got like a bone spur at the end of my tibia in my ankle on the left side, which means that it's just a little restricted in dorsiflexion when I'm bending my ankle. So it's really the only thing at the moment that I've got to make sure I get moving. Once I'm feeling good, so today is like, it's secondary, but I would say it's the biggest session of the week, longest session of the week. I'm doing the majority of my back squatting volume, like by a long shot. I'm doing the majority of my bench pressing volume for the single day that it is, and then heaps of accessories today. So it's really a work day, it's like a workhorse day, and it also really sets me up for my primaries. And because we're 12 days out, I don't know, it feels real different, this comp. Prior comps that I've done, like this is my first comp under Marcellus. Prior comps that I've done, the peaking strategy has been quite different. And I don't know, it's nice because the training coming into comp this time round, it's quite low pressure. It's like just do what you kind of normally do in your blocks, build nice momentum, and then just do what you normally do on your week 4 SPD, but it's competition day. So people are asking me like, what's the big numbers for like end of prep? Like, are you excited? I'm like, yeah, I'm just training, like just kind of doing what I normally do. And then I think it's going to be like a flicking of the switch come competition day. And it feels nice mentally to feel a lot more relaxed. Like, historically, I would get naturally quite stressed in those last couple of weeks because that's when the big lifts are coming. But that's almost behind me now. And now I'm just focused on having good training sessions. So you'll see that today. It's just going to be focused on like good quality of movement, good load selection, and just building. Yeah.
My name's Andrew. I'm a 66 kilo lifter, and I'll be going to Lithuania.
What did you just do? Few weeks ago at Australian Nationals?
Did 639 total, squatted 234, benched 145, and deadlifted 260.
What are your thoughts going into Lithuania?
Just gonna have fun, place as high as I can. It's not really any thing to lose, so finally gonna probably have fun and try to let it all out on the platform as best as possible.
See ya.
Ballpark today on squat, it's a double at 6. I've squatted 230 for 8 before high bar. So we think about a double at 6, it's a double with like roughly 4 reps in the tank. So if I'm feeling fine, 230 should be a good pick, or a little bit more, we'll see. My Marcellus likes me to aim to slightly undershoot, it's the way we run things. Especially coming into a comp where you have like nothing to prove. Again, you're trying to build trends. So 230 will be like, if I feel good, 230 will be a great pick. If I feel exceptional, you know, I will add a bit of weight to that. But I'm not really desperate to add load, because then after that, I've got 3x7 as based on the load that I pick. So it's a big session overall. I'll go plus 20 to 235. And I'm feeling just good, like I said, I go 230, so that's fine. Every little thing that you're doing, so you gotta put the thing on and it should go that way, but you do that way, you're like, fuck. Yeah. Can I say, it feels nice. What will we select for the top set? Quick little video replay confirmation. Good as a belt, so I think we'll go plus 20. Did a nice double there.
She already fixed, so I'm halfway there. Brown and back, could've changed my mind, I was halfway there. 100 meters, I just put 9 gal in a sprinter. 100 eaters, it won't fit in one SUV. SOS, somebody rescue me. I got too many. Last me the next 2 weeks. Alright, next
send it address to you, please.
SUV, the outside white, the inside brown like Michael Jack. More time than Bella Lyne and Trap. Spent like I don't even like my stack. Pistol came on an Irish ferry, let go in the sun.
That's the best I've felt in a minute. Strong, that's strong. So much better than last one. Also just like, I feel like from a balance standpoint, yeah, that felt on point.
Feel like you're fighting your feet a lot better?
Yeah man, just straight to the feet. Break the knees straight down, which is obviously how it should be. But I feel like last one, I was thinking about it a lot.
Yeah, and now it's natural.
Yeah, which is exactly what you want to be saying in a comp block, so very happy with that.
Very happy, baby. Very happy. Very happy. That girl outrageous, but she can't see because I got shades. Yeah, keep moving, let's go. The shade is your foundation. Darkest grey, the shade I'm in. Yeah, where the face is going. Happy, a famous thing. Doors are clean, games are things. My house part of the base station. Come on. Girls want to chase, it's a status thing.
Sevens don't get any easier.
Captain, I lead the army back. Ratio, I leave the party. Free Somalis, free the army.
Two sets together. I don't actually usually time my rest, but I'll throw that on just to show you guys what's normal for me. I won't even look at it. I'll just show you when I get back into it. Set of seven. Set of seven, reasonably hard. Mostly on the respiratory system. So I'll let my shit settle a bit. But you'll see, I'm not going to be waiting 10 minutes or something. Probably be like 4 or 5 minutes.
So the good thing about having percentage backoffs based on what you hit in the top set, firstly, the working sets reflect how strong you felt on the top set. So that's the first thing.
Second thing is there's kind of an insurance policy to make sure you don't be like overzealous on the top set, because if I just egregiously overshoot that top set, all the work is going to get heavier. So it's within my best interest for what I'm capable of to be true as possible on the top set, and then my working sets are going to be realistic based on that. So it's kind of a double win there. Everyone's just doing work, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
Like, we all chat here and there. We should catch up a lot before training, and then once we settle off afterwards. But during, you see, like, no matter who you're shooting, like, everyone's on task. It's what you want at a gym. That's the vibe.
Oh,
you're basketball now? Yeah, join Danny.
Yes, I will, actually. Yes, I will. Very good.
How are you working so far?
Doing bad.
Okay.
Just practicing, like, staying useful.
Okay, good, cool.
Hey, man.
Simple business.
Hot
today.
Yeah, so what, 30?
It's not even like that hot, but it's hotter than it's been lately. Do you know what I mean? It's been a little cooler lately. We've had some hot days here. I feel like before you guys started training here, it's one of those 40 days and whatnot.
I think we dodged the bullet
next year, don't worry. But you'll be adapted by that point.
Yeah.
You'll be fully adapted. You'll be the second version of yourself. The kind that starts sweating as soon as you walk in because your body's efficient. Anyways, I'm talking too much shit. I was timing my rest times. I'm ready to go, so let me see. Next minute, 15 minutes later. Nah, we good. Coming up to 4 minutes. Got a set of seven. My heart rate's not down, but I'm ready. Sometimes when you're doing volume, you just need to keep going. If you let your heart rate fully settle, you're probably gonna spend an hour doing three sets, or 40 minutes doing three sets. Not about it. Get it done. I got bench to do as well, so second set of three. Let's go. Suck a nigga, dig or something. Suck a nigga, dig or something. Suck a nigga, dig or something.
Suck a nigga, dig or something. Keep it moving, yeah. Nice.
Come on.
Deposit, I picked up another bag. Like, fuck it, I'ma count while I'm in it. I heard planes flying, crowds screaming, money counting chains, clanking shit. I guess that's how it sounds. I ain't joking, do it sound like I'm kidding. I've been making like 2,000 a minute. So high up in the clouds, I was swimming. Good. I'm just in the work now, so. Only bitch, I get chill. And he's gonna be coaching me on comp day. Keep me accountable. Obviously, I got my coach who I check in with, so he gives me feedback. But it's always mad having someone as invested as Danny in the lead up, because even there, on my second set, it was a good set. But he just quickly said to me, hey, let's take it a little bit deeper. And that's great, because I'm not a mile high or anything, but I know with my squad, it takes very much an attitude of like pushing in quite aggressively to hit depth. And hands down, this is like 23 reps today of working weight. That's just one rep on the low bar day. So this is where the pattern comes from. This is where like the autonomy of depth comes from. So it's always nice to have a training partner like Danny who's gonna be coaching me on the day to kind of just call those things out. It's really like casually. So we'll take it a little bit deeper on the next one, make sure that happens.
You're amazing.
Hashtag stay honest.
Just happy to be here. Look over there, look over there.
What am I looking at?
The next POV is going to be over Danny's shoulder.
I got the perfect depth angle.
Over Danny's shoulder, through the fan.
I got the eyes for it.
And maintaining the pressure and gas.
Yeah.
So sometimes when I maintain the pressure, that's where like, it feels a bit more powerful to just get just like on the border.
Yeah.
So I just need to make sure that it's like that, overdoing it without losing the pressure.
You're not going to fail, so it's just
No, you're right, you're 100%. You're 100% right.
You'll be right.
No, I'll be fine. I just wanted to cross-check that.
Yeah.
It's alright, we're good. Danny's one feet, Matt.
You want me to watch from death?
Yeah, we'll be deep, don't worry. Okay. If I'm fucking high, man, say something about the
I might not be able to tell depth if I'm also spotting, but I'll do my best.
The camera will tell everything.
He's got a kill shot on. It's about to go down. It's about to go down. Realized I forgot to call you back. Here's that autograph for your daughter. I wrote it on the starter cap. Stand, son. Listen, man, dad isn't mad, but how you gonna name yourself after a dead gun and have a man bun? Eyes open, undenied. We're supplying smoke at the fire stove. Say you got me in a scope, but you grazed me. I say one call the Interscope and you swayzy. Your reply got the crowd yelling moves. So before you die, let's see who can out petty who with your corny lines. Slim your old out, Kelly fool, but I'm 45 and I'm still out selling you. By 29, I had 3 albums in the blue.
Yeah.
Now let's talk about something I don't really do. Going with someone's daughter's mouth, stealing food.
Yep.
But you're a fucking molehill. Now I'll make a mountain out of you. Hold chill, like I can put the chrome barrel to my own mail. Gonna get you in a falling out. So you run up on me like a phone bill, spraying lead.
Dead,
that's a
yeah,
still.
Come on, man.
Are you eating cereal or oatmeal? What the fuck's in the bowl, man?
Yeah.
These are Cheerios. Cause I'm taking a shitling, Kelly. I need reading material. Dictionary. Yo, Slim, your last 4 albums suck. Go back to recovery. Oh, shoot, that was 3 albums ago. What do you know? Oops. Know your facts before you come at me, little goof. Luxury, oh, you broke
the bitch. Up.
I had enough money in O2 to burn it in front of you.
That was 3 cents in life. You whacked me.
It's
15
funny,
minutes.
But so true. I'd rather be 80-year-old me than 20-year-old you.
Bench press, pretty similar day. I think it's a triple at 6. 3x7 after it, so same, but only minus 12%. So a little bit less of a drop back for the bench, which makes sense for anyone who's ever written a program or coaches. Bench has been feeling really good on some days, and then other days, like just good. No real bad days. Last week's session on the V2 this day was really good. I think I benched 150 for 3, so I'll increase that. So I feel a lot stronger than week 1. Last block in the week 4, like, I was smashed after that. So week 1, Not alright, but I feel a lot better this week. So here we go. The first block where I spent three sessions of the three, so all three bench days on the V2 bench. Which for me is quite a bit different to benching on something that's softer. So I'm getting there. I can bench 155 for three today out of six. It's good, but we'll see how we do. General vibe after squatting. Generally, I'll kind of motor through my working sets on the squats, but then I kind of treat that as like phase one of the session, and then I'll rest for a solid amount. So I've been resting now for like 8-9 minutes. I'm probably gonna chill it for another few minutes. I just do little things like hydrate, make sure my warm-ups are planned out for my bench next, all those little things. Then I'll do some prep work for bench. That'll take 5 minutes, and then I'll start bench pressing. That's just like the cadence of my session. When I'm in the work, I'm like fucking on. I'm getting back into sets pretty much as soon as I can, most of the time. And then when I go to another discipline from squat to bench press, I'll like separate that, and then I'll move on. Feels nice. And it means I can just kind of like, if I have to change my mindset from squat to bench press, I can do that as well, right? So that's the way I play. It's kind of how comps run as well. Comps are moving, squat, 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 warm-ups, 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 attempt, attempt, attempt. And then it's like, hey, rest while the other group squats, right? So it's kind of the same thing. Not why I do it, but it's a nice coincidence as well.
The most handsome Asian at Breakthrough. That's your title, not Anthony. The most handsome Asian.
Take smaller jumps than some. For someone who benches 190, my jumps are a little bit on the smaller side, but I find for bench press, that helps me just make sure I know how I'm feeling. Bigger jumps, I find just a little bit harder to read, and also my tech just feels a little bit more locked in with those smaller jumps, so you'll see that today. Again, just tracking the little nuances of my arm angle, and then normal comp bench for the next one, which will be 110. I'll go like 130, 140, then I'll split off if I feel really good. I'll go 150, and then jump up. I'll double check that. But essentially, the second last warm up, I'll decide sort of like A or B, if I'm feeling good or great. Quite similar to the mindset of the squat. So I get handouts on bench now. I didn't used to. I used to do soft run racks, but I've enjoyed getting assistance. Kind of always happy to go either way. I do a little bit of practice on both, but so far getting assistance on rack has been nice. I think that my old concern used to be that like they could stuff it up for you, but I think that my mind has changed. I feel like if you're good at soft run racks, there's less responsibility on the person helping you. So even if they do an average job, most of the time you're still gonna be okay. On 10, feeling like 105. feels good. Guys in here that I coach, we always joke, like, get the bar on your back, and they'll be like, ooh, feels like 15 today, like, just being silly. Just to sort of say, I'm feeling strong. Because we started here, and then it happens. Unless it doesn't. I don't make the rules. But on a serious note, I do feel pretty good on bench today. I can shoot saw pretty early. How does it feel in the hands? How does the position feel? Like I said before, I'm spending more and more time on the Alico V2 because I'll be competing on that bench. And I find when I really get foot position and overall position nailed down, it's like so much better. And I think as a coach, I know that that's just the reality of this bench. It's a little more harsh on you when you make errors or you're kind of out of position. So just trying to take as much time as I can to start properly. And so far it's feeling good. So keep on that rhythm. Time chain, niggas ain't rumbling no more. Now what for, hungry for more. If you solo leave, vocal listen close and you can hear grumbling. Bow tie and I'm still munching. Big bag, never fear fumbling. Won't smoke, nigga, don't choke. I'm a whole fucking nicotine company. Dream for the army, not a navy. How could you ever try to play me? Kill them on the song, right, walk about the booth through the Westbrook like a baby. Up, I never fall out with the bro. Okay. Hey, when your family turn the phone, we had a penthouse on the... Yeah. 140. 147 to 150. Then that's the range, but this one will tell where we're at. If I go 147, I'm feeling fine. And I'll take more than last week. If I go 150, I feel amazing. So keep the options open. What should I do? Feels good. I'm gonna go 147 because I did 150 for 3 last week. Plus 5 kilos is really solid. If I undershoot it by a little bit, I can be more aggressive next week. And just gotta bag the dubs. I'm on the cusp of like going up that way to 157, but I think the smart call is to go 147, 155 today.
What do you think of Maddie's bench?
It's very good. Very easy day for him. Standards, immaculate. I gave him very fair press calls. I don't think it was anything too crazy or too lenient, so he should be in good hands. I know he's got his primary SBD on a Saturday. Definitely a lot heavier than what he usually does, so if he can maintain that standard going into the Saturday, literally don't have to think by the time it comes to comp day. It's literally just picking how many kilos he's got per attempt, and that's all we need to worry about, because technical execution is getting better and better every single week that I see him, so it's good.
So what are the plans? As his handler, what are your plans going into the next comp?
I have no clue. No, I'm joking. We're looking at his numbers. I'll probably take that final week to review everything once I sit down in front of the computer and actually look at the numbers so I have it like actually on paper. But most of our conversations have been in talking, in passing, the way I'm watching him move. So based off that, like, everything's moving really well, but once we can get like attempt plans, like potential aggressive, conservative, on plan jumps, then we should be sweet. But aside from that, on the day, just gonna be vibing. I think it's just me handling him, so it's a nice cruisy day. Gotta match his energy, have fun, and come back to Sydney after.
Excuse me, sir. Watch me dilate my eyes. You're gonna lose that lens in a second, mister.
He likes it. I can see the...
That's a lovely eyes.
Can you see like the individual like pieces?
Oh, such a good camera. Fuck. That's crazy. You're like hazel as hell.
Are my eyes dilating and...
Refocusing? Wait a second.
Hold on. Let me switch to manual.
There we go. Oh,
yeah. Go dilate them.
you just widen your eyes or what? Or you look past it?
I'm trying to look past it and then look right at it.
Yeah.
I don't know, I don't see much.
Damn. Mm-hmm. It's alright. Next time, we'll practice.
Next try, LSD, go. Alright, let's get it. I think
How heavily do you usually jump week to week on this day?
Like up to 5 kilos is like 2 would be modest and 5 would be aggressive.
Yeah.
Because I'm not going to hit that week more though.
Yeah, you're going to
chill out on Monday. Next week. No, like that'll still be the week 3. This is the week 4. The week 4, SPD is like comp day. That's day 1. And then I won't hit this day on the week 4. So I don't want to be silly, but I can afford to like probably take a little bit more kilos.
Yeah. What's roughly?
150. Yeah, I think the top 5 would be like rocket.
Yeah,
it'd be really nice. It's nice. Hit my primary 2 days ago, and that was one of those days where benches like felt good, but I wasn't quite it. And today now, consistently, this day's felt on fire. And I know that last time Marcellus and I tapered back and did a testing day just in the gym, bench was kind of just like this. It was like good some days, great other days. And then once we tapered back, it really showed up on the day. So obviously I'm hopeful that'll happen, but it's nice to have at least one day that's feeling like absolutely on fire. Yeah, it's always a work in progress, but I feel like bench is definitely getting better.
It was time to marry the game, and I say, yeah, I do. If you want it, you got line hearted. They love me when I was stuck in their head, and when I departed, I go and get it regardless. Draw like I'm an artist, no crawling, went straight to walking with foreigners in my garages. All foreign bitches menaging, fucking sucking and swallowing anything for a dollar. They tell me, get him, I got him. I did it without an album.
It felt like a little wonky when I set up, but it didn't matter.
Little nigga, I'm on fire. I see that. I don't say a word. What's on my grind and I got what I deserve. Fuck nigga. Hold up, wait a minute. Y'all thought I was finished. When I would ask tomorrow,
I'm really happy with that. Mostly from a selection point of view. Felt stronger. Probably felt like on average I execute singles a little better than my rep work. So I probably felt a little stronger on the last warm-up than I felt during the triple. But again, that's why that was a good choice to just go like, 155. Just letting you know it was a good pick. And now we figure out what we got next. So I just went 136 there. It's like pounds and percentages and shit, so I get as close as I can with the chips we have here.
Why the importance of being so precise with your weight?
I think that it comes down to semantics at the particular load that you're doing. So it really doesn't matter if this is like 136.5, 136, 137. That's not really the point. The point is that the program on a wider scale has an element of precision and intention, that if you're gonna bother calculating anything and you have the ability to be precise, there is no reason not to be precise. It's not to be like elite or anything like that, or that this is going to be something special for me. It just means that if you decide that it's going to be like -12% and you can load it to this degree, there is absolutely no reason not to do that outside of being lazy. So it's super easy for me to do. That is as simple as that. And it comes down to executing a plan. I'm just the athlete, just executing what I'm told to do to the best of my ability. End of story. So I think it was 136.4, so obviously 136.5 is closer. That's it, don't worry about it, says it, said it.
Roll, lot of pink toes, break it off. Marjorie, you didn't know. We about
Jesus has made the bitch go sicko mode. All the status, I busted down the bitch the baddest. The rest in the attic, I doubled the money, the mathematics. My car's the fastest, I'm flipping the bitch, I'm knowing genetics. I'm Elliot Diamond, I pull up the wrist, she needs some glasses. It's hard to catch them, I pull up control, I can move in madness. They thought it would matter, we ballin' on niggas, go get you a basket. The money complete,
I buy me a rap, but it cut me a cool. Looks like you're almost gonna anticipate one, but it was good. Yeah. Everything else was like patient.
Even like my body language on the chest is better, my less anticipatory. Actually sitting on the chest a little more. I find that like it feels better to be a little heavier on the chest. Like not sink, but that idea. Yeah. Being super light and not being going ready to go feels weak.
Yeah, you had that issue where it was like lightly touching.
Yeah, like so a spotter day.
You adjusted
bullshit
it. So.
Spotter day. I was working up to my week 4 bench. Literally spotter pause like above the chest, my last one. I was like, oh, the fuck? So, that feels good.
Yeah,
that's nice.
Still cold, but me, I can't lose.
I know you're getting confused. Then what's the importance of being consistent on your back downs?
Well, the back downs or the working sets is the majority of the work. So we're talking from a neurological standpoint, i.e. the patterns that your body learns through practice, it literally comes from repetition. So let's say that I'm perfect with my execution on my top set and then sort of rushing it or skimping the standards on the working sets. Maybe 90% of the work I've done that day, 90% of the practice I've done that day has been bad or subpar. So the mindset is almost that this is more important practice than the top set. The top set is an expression of strength. You still want it to be executed well, but you certainly don't want to drop that away for the working sets. It's going to create the runway for future days. And that's where you actually get stronger. That's where you actually get better. So I try to keep the standards as high as possible, be harsh on myself, have people like Danny, any training partners. You know, I constantly ask, hey, how are the pauses there? Can you call for me? How's my depth? We all gas ourselves up, so it's good to have honest training partners. And to your question, very important to be making sure the working sets are of the highest standard.
This is one of my dogs,
Leo.
He's very cute. And my other dog. It's Nala.
Also very cute.
Okay. Back to training.
That's pretty better. No shit.
Yeah.
What I'm noticing is actually having a bit more weight on the chest feels better than being like shirt-like, which is a certain style. And I've gone between those two styles, you know, throughout my time, but consistently coming back to not dumping it on the chest, just having a little bit more of the weight of the bar on my chest so it sits, and then responding. So that's feeling really nice. I'm getting there. Spanish is hard. My fiance is Spanish, so I'm trying to learn. I'm getting tutored twice a week. We're getting there. Got some of the basics down. I'm committed for the long haul. I want to be fluent. But challenging for anyone out there who's learning a second language or knows two languages. Respect. Not much to say, just good quality work on squats and the bench. I'll pack this up and we might might summarize things a little bit and wrap it up. So, squats and bench done. That's pretty much half the session. So now I'll move into accessories, which I'll talk about in a second. But how we feel about today, squats, exceptional. Commented a little bit on the fly, but very strong feeling day. High bar is my bread and butter when it comes to the sort of back squat volume. And the pattern feels right, depth is really good, strength is in a really good spot, so that's excellent. But beyond that, there was a really nice autonomy today. What I mean by that was there was minimal thinking about technique. It was more just doing, which is exactly what you aim for, not only over time, but towards the end of blocks, and particularly at competition. I want to be walking out to the platform without much in my mind to focus on. I want to be able to just do and just be. Carrying on to bench press, much of the same. Probably this secondary, definitely actually, this secondary day has been performing really, really, really well. And this is much more of a market to me right now than my primary has been. But the primary coming up will also tell a lot. And as I mentioned throughout the session, when we take the bench back, it's sort of different to my past experiences. It really shows up. So, you know, I just need to keep doing good training. I don't really need to invest too much thought into what I'm lifting or anything like that. I can leave all those decisions to my coach. My focuses are my focuses, and I outline those today, which is to pause well, get calls, be consistent, all right, pick good loads, which I did that really, really well today. So fantastic bench day. Accessories look like weighted dips, hack squats, flat press with feet up, lateral raises, triceps. So the hack squat dips and the dumbbell press would be like sort of in that sort of loop of like sort of primary accessories, like really important in the grand scheme of the volume that I do. Whereas like laterals and triceps, like a little bit less so, but treating them all is important. Probably take me about an hour to get through that. So it ends up being, you know, about half of this session. It's challenging, getting through three sets on each of that after doing all that work there. But it's good, just get hydrated, keep it chill, keep moving through at a nice pace. Because I also have work tonight with some PT clients, so I do have some things that I need to be done by. But overall, pretty outstanding session. I call it the camera buff. it was a good crew today. Happens to be a public holiday today. I normally don't train with the full squad like this Saturday. But it was really nice having everyone in and supporting. So yeah, keen about that. 12 days to go. Just gonna really try and loop together good sessions like the barbell mentioning today. Not too much pressure, just loop together good sessions. My goal for comp is to rock up with like a professional, clinical, clean package to hit the targets across all three lifts that my coach lays out, and to really start this sort of like next chapter of the journey, because this is really like the start of that next chapter. I've started working with a new coach. I'm 9-10 months deep. Now I'm doing my first comp with him. I'm moving to the 105s. It's like all these things kind of happening. So looking for a strong, clean start. Yeah.